Hachette Audio presents Your Pregnancy, Your Way. Everything you need to know about natural pregnancy and childbirth. Written by Allison Hill, MD, with Sheila Curry Oaks. Read by Allison Packard, with an introduction by Allison Hill, MD.
Dedication. To the mothers who have the courage to insist on a natural and mindful birth experience, and to the doctors and midwives who are dedicated to providing care in a safe and respectful way. Introduction. Hi, I'm Dr. Allison Hill. In my 20-year career as an OBGYN, I've delivered thousands of babies and have seen every type of birth. A mother relaxing in a warm bath, breathing deeply with her contractions. A woman being wheeled down the halls of the hospital for an emergency cesarean as blood pours from her placenta previa. A woman who has an epidural listening to music and talking excitedly with her family about the future. Each scene is different, but as the top of a baby's head emerges, I can feel my own heart racing in my chest. I love to steal a glance at the faces of the family as soon as they see their son or daughter for the first time. More important, I can breathe a sigh of relief that the baby is safe. But what type of birth is best? Some would argue that having your baby at home, surrounded by supportive family and friends, and with minimal medical intervention, is the way it should be done. Others view childbirth as risky and would only want to have a baby in a hospital where a doctor, anesthesiologist, and all of the current technology are available. There are arguments to be made on each side of this debate, and I don't think there will ever be a clear consensus. I believe that the focus shouldn't be on what type of birth is best, but rather on how to achieve the safest, most personalized, respectful care in all possible settings. I was anxious during my own pregnancy, and I'm an obstetrician. I believed everything that really mattered was almost sure to go right, but I also knew that things could go wrong. Although my delivery didn't go exactly as planned, luckily, my own OB and I had agreed about how to make my pregnancy as safe as possible while achieving my vision for the birth, even if that meant making choices that would differ from the way most doctors would handle things. I had the inside track. That's not the way it works for everyone. It may seem surprising that obstetricians don't always make decisions purely on the basis of the most up-to-date medical practice and what is best for the patient. Our patients have a right to that kind of care. They should feel that their doctor is on their side, not just at their side. But the truth is, sometimes we make decisions based on other concerns, such as the threat of malpractice lawsuits, our own preferences and training, hospital policies, and personal convenience. The good news is that you, as a mother-to-be, can enable your obstetrician to provide the best care by working together in a way that your doctor will welcome. This book is my opportunity to reflect candidly on what I have learned as a busy obstetrician and to explore the unspoken facets of this field. What I have written may be considered controversial. I'm here to tell you that much of the advice you hear from friends, pregnancy websites, and even doctors isn't based on scientific evidence. Numerous conventional medical practices need to change, and we know it. Why then do we stick to an outdated way of doing things, disseminating unfounded advice? To put it simply, because that's the way things have always been done. I will explain the basis of medical decision-making and how to empower yourself to work side-by-side with your doctor or midwife on this journey. This book will help you understand the birth process so you may have realistic expectations for what may happen and what is and is not in your control. The more clearly you understand what you want and the better you are able to adapt to whatever comes your way, the better your birth experience will be. New mothers and their babies are best off if the mother is happy and confident. The pregnancy goes more smoothly and any problems that come up seem less worrisome. Even the mother's relationship with her baby gets off to a better start when she has a positive birth experience. But the definition of a positive experience varies greatly from woman to woman. I have seen some mothers who know exactly what they want from the beginning and are able to achieve all of their goals. Others were able to adjust their expectations and have a satisfying experience despite their birth plans being altered at every step along the way. Unfortunately, still others are needlessly disappointed in themselves and their birth because things didn't go as planned and they had an epidural or required a cesarean. I don't want to give the impression that you can pick exactly how you want your birth to be and it will follow that script. Medical issues may arise for you or your baby that make it impossible, or once you are in labor, you may simply not want to do it. But as you plan for a natural pregnancy and birth, this book will help you navigate through any unforeseen complications that come your way so that you may stay as close as possible to your original vision. Your birth can be on your terms, feeling that you are part of the team and that your goals are respected. I hope that what you hear here will empower you to be successful however you bring your baby into the world. Instead of focusing on the small details of how their baby came into the world, my patients who have enjoyed their births the most have shifted their focus to the final positive outcome, learned to see the big picture, avoided rigid judgment from others, and eased up on the perfectionism. The ability to remain flexible and let go of what should happen will serve as a great asset during the many years of motherhood and child-rearing to come. Natural pregnancy and childbirth is a wonderful choice, but might not be right for you. Whether or not you stick to your original plan, have multiple interventions or none at all, doesn't determine whether you are a good mother. At your child's birth, your journey as a mother is just beginning.
Chapter 1. What does a natural birth mean, anyway? Women have been giving birth for centuries. What can be more natural than that? Well, it is not quite so simple. For each and every woman, natural means something different. The definition depends on where you live, the customs in your family, and, most importantly, whether you view pregnancy as inherently safe or inherently risky. In recent times, the word natural is often used to characterize things we assume to be healthier, safer, and better for us. For some women, having a natural birth simply means that they want to deliver vaginally instead of by cesarean section. To others, it means not using pain medication, although an IV and fetal monitoring are welcome. Some believe that all births are natural, as long as what is done is best for the mom and the baby. Others think natural implies avoiding the hospital altogether and trusting their body to give birth the way women have done for generations, delivering in the familiar setting of their own home or in a peaceful birthing center without beeping machines and rushed medical personnel. Calling a birth natural brings up the question of what would constitute an unnatural birth. For those of us in the medical field, the opposite of a natural birth is one with interventions. Yet, in lay terms, to say that a birth is not natural implies that the event is not as good or even harmful. Is a birth experience artificial or abnormal when medical interventions are chosen or become necessary? How my patients define natural childbirth. Not using pain medication. Delivering vaginally. Minimizing medical intervention. Choosing pain. Having an unmedicated birth. Bringing a baby into the world alive. Having control over my delivery. Trusting my body to give birth the way it was meant to. Having a baby the way I want. Influences on our view of childbirth. Thanks to Hollywood, when most of us picture labor, we think of a woman on her back in a hospital bed, surrounded by machines, screaming and sweating, perhaps yelling a string of curse words as she bears down with each contraction. The father-to-be grips her hand, white-faced and helpless, feeling faint. A tense nurse shouts instructions as a doctor catches the baby's emerging head. Labor is fast, furious, and intense. We almost never see labor depicted as a relaxed, peaceful experience. Watching the process play out in its slow, methodical way, sometimes lasting for days, wouldn't make for a dramatic moment in a movie. It is no surprise that many women approach labor fearfully, focusing on the pain, rather than anticipating it as the extraordinary event it can be. Our view of pregnancy and childbirth is also influenced by the experiences of women who have gone before us, the well-meaning family and friends.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.